Inflow and infiltration, or INI, is basically groundwater or rainwater that gets into the sanitary sewer system. It robs valuable capacity out of the sanitary sewer system. Inflow is rainwater that gets into the sanitary sewer system through direct connections like downspouts or sump pumps. It is an instantaneous result on the sewer, so the sewer will spike very quickly from the water that comes in from those connections. Infiltration is water that gets in through leaky joints and cracks in the manhole or the lateral pipes or the sanitary sewer mains. Infiltration makes a much longer resultant on the sanitary sewer system. We can actually watch on a graph how the infiltration will come in very slowly and take a few days to actually drain out.
We conducted a pilot study a few years ago, and based on the pilot study, we did a lot of smoke testing, a lot of manhole inspections. The city did some TV work, and we tried to identify as many defects we could find, or inflow and infiltration sources as we can find. And what resulted in that is we found a lot of both public and private sector defects, both defects contributing to inflow and infiltration to the sewer system. Well, what that does is cause the many issues that we talked about with water and basement and discharges, but also it affects the treatment plant too. So from the pilot study, we took that and the city presented it to the city council. And from the city council, they developed this INI program. And as part of their INI program is they're going to remove both public sector inflow and infiltration sources, but also private sector inflow and infiltration. And what makes this unique is the city is paying for those cost-effective private sector sources to be removed. A lot of cities have tried many different ways to do this, by enforcement, through cutting off water, by really using the iron fist method of requiring citizens to repair their defects, their private defects. Whereas the city has realized the fact that we can do this more cost effectively. We can solve some of our water and basement issues, solve some of our overflow issues, solve some of our treatment plan issues if we do this. So the city is very aggressive in going after this private sector defects, and this is what makes them very unique, not only in the state of Missouri, but also in the nation. And it's receiving a lot of attention for other cities wanting to reduce their inflow and infiltration and how to do it cost effectively.
The public rehabilitation is part of the project as well. The city of Columbia is going to be addressing the public side of the system. They're currently doing work. We're putting in liners. It's basically a pipe inside of a pipe to rehabilitate the existing pipe that's underground without having to disturb the surface. Everything's done underground. It's a trenchless type technology. We try to utilize that wherever we can, even with a sewer manhole. A lot of times we can rehabilitate a sewer manhole from inside the manhole without having to excavate around it. So anything that we can do to minimize the disruption, the city of Columbia is going to have, and they currently have a program in place to address the public side of the system. So you will be seeing a lot of work take place throughout the city of Columbia to address the public side of the system. There are pipes that will have to be enlarged or completely replaced, rerouted in some cases. Manholes that need to be installed or rehabilitated will be part of the public side of the project.
We have started our citywide INI program in the areas of town where we found to be the highest concentration of inflow infiltration. And that first area we're calling Flat Branch Basin D. When we did the flow monitoring back in 2000 as part of our master plan project, this area was shown to have the highest ratio between dry weather flow and wet weather flow in town. So that's why we started there. The next area of town that we're going from Flat Branch Basin D is just to the east and north of Flat Branch Basin D, and what we call Flat Branch Basin A and B. They're basically in the upper portions of the Flat Branch watershed. These, again, were the number two and number three areas of peak flow in town. I believe there's in the neighborhood of 3,500 residences or businesses in these three areas. We're doing building inspections, as well as smoke testing of the public sewers, manhole inspections to do a complete sewer system evaluation. Well, the program is set up to remove defects as we find them, namely sump pumps, downspouts, and then clean out caps. The city ordinance states that any source that allows INI to get into the system is a is a violation of city ordinance.
The City of Columbia has taken a very proactive approach. A lot of cities are reactive to the sewer system. When problems occur, they address them. But City of Columbia is being proactive. They're out there, they're trying to identify and find the problems in their system and then fix them. It's the INI that they're trying to find the leaks in the system and trying to fix those problems so they reduce the amount of rainwater, groundwater that gets into the system. And ultimately, by doing this, it's going to save the taxpayers a tremendous amount of money, because by reducing the flows, they don't have to increase the size of the system, the pipes, the pump stations, and the treatment plants. So it's a very positive approach that the City of Columbia is taking.